We have only one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. There is one God who is the Father of all people. Not only is God above all others, but He works by using all of us, and He lives in all of us. Christ has generously divided out His gifts to us. As the scriptures say, when He went up to the highest place, He led away many prisoners and gave gifts to people. Those words come from Ephesians chapter 4, verses 5 to 8. I heard a prisoner say, I am in prison, but I am free. I always thought that such a statement was just a brave recognition of freedom in Christ, even though earthly physical freedom had been taken away. But I was wrong. Every man and woman alive today, or who has ever been alive, is a prisoner. We are either a prisoner of Satan, sin, and this world system, or we are a prisoner of Christ. If you are a prisoner of Jesus Christ, then you are free indeed. Truthfully, a prison may be a wonderful place to be. When you are a prisoner of Satan, you are battered by every evil the devil can throw at you. You are not only his prisoner, but because of your sin nature, you become his slave as well. You do the bidding of the evil one, even though you may be repulsed by the very things that you do. But when you are a prisoner of Christ, you are free to walk in the righteousness of Jesus and to be immersed in the love of God, even as you share that love with others. All the while, as a prisoner of Christ, the world cannot snatch you away from Him or really harm you at all. Oh yes, you will suffer and be harassed by Satan, but he cannot touch your eternal relationship with Jesus. Free will is this: you have the freedom to choose your prison. You will either choose the prison of this world and ultimately experience eternal death, or you will choose the prison of Jesus Christ and ultimately live with Him forever in heaven. Lord Jesus, I choose to be your prisoner and live forever in the freedom of heaven. Lord, lock me in to your heart and never let me go. May you, Jesus, be praised forever. Amen.